mining is mostly what Minecraft is about. Whether you're playing survival, PvP, or other minigames, mining is usually involved in it. Some people will make challenges for themselves, such as mining 1 million blocks or mining for 24 hours. But those are nothing compared to what I'm about to tell you. Today, we will be looking at a man that almost accomplished something that was considered insane by most players. This is the untold story of Hugh Cass. Mining to most players are boring and would be foolish to grind for, as it wasn't any useful other than rewarding you with some defense and extra drops from an ore. But a group of people would think otherwise. There is a guild called Skyborn. The guild used to consist of many players with high skill average at the time. Some of them were even the first person to reach level 50 on one of the skills. From what I told you, you already know this guild was serious about skill grinding. Back then, people only care about your skill average, so if you had a low skill average, you wouldn't be accepted to a top guild. Many players would grind a variety of skills because getting from 40 to 50 is the same as 0 to 40. They will often get one skill to 40 and then go to the next one, but some players wanted something else. In the community, there was a small percent of players that were trying to get a level 50 skill that nobody has gotten. A player who goes by Hugh Cass was part of it, and what he was going for would have shocked most players. He wanted to find a skill that to most players would consider impossible, challenging or time-consuming, and mining was perfect for it. Because of how slow and useless mining was, people would do other skills such as combat or foraging, which would reward you in damage. This was also when damage was the main focus of everyone, so that means there would almost be nobody doing any other skills than those. Hugh Cass would begin mining at around the 13th of December, 2019. He was already mining 31, which was quite high, and just shortly after, he would up to mining 36 in just about a week. At this time, he was also number 1 on the leaderboard and would stay that way for the next 2 months. Most of the players on the leaderboard would not even level once, but that's probably because they are using minions to level their mining. Because of how slow it was, it's understandable why they didn't mine manually. But Hugh Cass wanted something bigger than that. He would level once about every 3 days and would continue doing so. Although the XP rate was quite bad, it's still impressive how he can level up almost at once every 3 days, to the point where some members within the guild has questioned his legitimacy.
He gets high money XP without diamond minions, which are harder to macro but gives less XP. His island is almost always closed, even to guild members. His gas chambers are set up so that his unstable armor can kill them with zero interactions. He could get so much more XP by using all 20 plus of his minion slots into one large gas chamber, then just blowing them. Again, hardest macro. Works a full-time job. Kinda sucks to throw a guild member under the bus like that, but I couldn't ignore the evidence.
But to back this up, he will post an image of him hitting the next level each time he hits it, until he stopped. With each day passing by, he would question his sanity and ask himself, why is he doing it? But would still keep mining. He will rant about Hypixel not banning the players who nuked Endstone and saying how it makes him feel like he is wasting his time. He didn't expect this to take this long and has ultimately lost all his interest. Before we continue, I will need to explain something. Before the release of God Pods, guild used to collect guild funds to make splashes for the guild. This can be a requirement to a guild or just simply a donation. One of the staffs in Skyburn was in charge of keeping the guild funds for splashes. Because he was Alchemy 50, it seemed like it was meant to be. But throughout the months, the splashes for the guild had started decreasing due to the new rule that Hypixel had started enforcing. What we were doing was putting down minions such as Glowstone and Redstone on our other profile so we don't have to donate through our own money, and instead on another profile that's giving us passive splashes. Since then, we haven't gotten many splashes, so one day, two members within the guild, who goes by Crude Reality and Jupiter Tree, will ask one of the staffs in Skyborn at the time where the guild funds were going to, and started accusing him of keeping it all to himself. While asking that, they will also question how legit the guild was and how they're not actually cheater-free. This is where Hugh Cass' story would come to an end. Remember how he said he has lost all interest in grinding legitimately. Well, in the same day, he will go and set up a macro to help him mine cobblestone. And unfortunately, like most cases, his lobby has to start it and send him to the hub. Because servers are constantly restarting, there was no way a macro can return you back to Skyblock, unless you... well, I don't know. So he was found by someone that was within the guild at the time, spinning around in the prototype lobby. Not only that, JupiterTree was also tracking him at the time, seeing how long he was on for prior to the incident. From tracking him, he has found that Qcast would sometimes mine for up to 24 hours during a workday. After they have revealed Qcast has been macroing, he would delete his profile almost immediately. Everybody was shocked to see this and was in disbelief. Sadly, it was the truth. Whether he will come back or not will remain a mystery. Or maybe he has already came back but in a different username. We will never know.